Now let's see, where should we go now? Let's head into deepest Europe. Let's go to Austria, Vienna to be exact, and meet my good friend Juan Garcia-Herreros.
Wow, Lars, you really know how to say my name. Amazing.
It's easiest for me to say your world famous stage name of Snow Owl.
Thank you. Yes, he's always with me.
We've interviewed several times now. We've done London. I went out to Australia to interview, and now we're back in the UK. You've got so many roles, though, as award-winning composer, arranger, bass player. I've even seen you conducting.
Yeah, I like to always surprise people with my hidden abilities. I always prefer to be underestimated than overestimated. So those skills you pick up over the years, especially from special interest and just a desire to always grow and pursue excellence. So that was a nice surprise when we were recording the trailer music for Dune that Hans Zimmer let me conduct the sessions in Vienna in the Synchron stage.
It's a lot on your shoulders. That must have been so good. I actually saw you post not long ago, like a collaboration video where there's lots of you playing different instruments as a birthday, happy birthday to Hans, and you're playing a trombone.
Well, that's one of the blessings from COVID, from this time right now, is to have the time to fulfill musical dreams that I always had. You know, I carried a trombone book with me since high school. I had this book with me my whole life for trombone etudes that I used to practice on the electric bass. And I said, you know, one day I'm going to learn it on the trombone. And it happened. The blessing happened to have the time, that extra time that you wouldn't have from all the traveling that that we used to do. And I've dedicated it to learning the trombone, and I'm just in love with it because it'll develop me even more as in a melodic sense, in a composer sense, with understanding the brass instruments more. So I love it.
That's incredible. It's also like the saxophone, all that brassy. It's sort of breathy, almost voicey. So the underlying theme here, of course, is like you mentioned, COVID has wiped out the live music for a moment. And several years building up to that, you were touring in Hans's band, as they say, with 200 odd people in it, choirs, orchestras, such a massive scale. It's like like bands of the 70s going on tour with Arctics, lorries following. You must miss that terribly.
Not only do I miss it, it's such a tight-knitted family, also with the orchestra. And I have to mention it in this interview that people need to realize that our orchestra, that was from the Belarusian Bolshoi opera. And they are, right now, Belarus is going through some of the most terrible political turmoil and protests. And all my beautiful friends from the orchestra, they really need help right now and support, that people become aware of what they're literally fighting for, their human rights and freedom right now. And I miss them so much. And I hope that with this interview, we can also bring a little bit of awareness about what's happening to them.
And also during this quiet period, like so many people, I know for a fact you don't like sitting still. What have you been up to?
Again, if you look at this sort of world reset button, which is happening, and you if you embrace it, if you accept it, then you start to look for answers in deeper places that you wouldn't have looked before. I've been able to concentrate much more on engineering, composing, especially for soundtracks, my sound design collective that I have with all my friends here in Austria called Totem Warriors has been developing.
Each warrior's heart, a totem sings. The audio experience it deserves.
And of course, the long-awaited release of The Red Road, we will be releasing our next animation video with La Pájara Pinta Studios from Colombia, a little world collaboration there, to follow up for what we did on the Blue Road with She Became a Thousand Birds, we will be releasing the first single, Hush, the animation video in November. Hopefully November 15th, everybody will finally see the video for the next story.
Oh, I look forward to that. I enjoyed the Blue Road immensely. I mean, that was quite intricate. How many people were on that?
Oh, a lot. I think we had about 25 people on that album, if I'm correct. And we had members of the Vienna Philharmonic and the Radio Symphony Orchestra. We had African legends. We had Bulgarian legends. We had a mixture of all the tribes. And the Red Road will be a huge surprise, as everybody already saw from The Horde, the first single that we released at the beginning of last year.
Are you primarily on the bass all the way through that, or are you playing other instruments?
That one is purely electric bass, but it's kind of it's my homage to all of the heavy metal icons that influenced me my whole life, especially Cliff Burton and David Ellefson. So there's a lot in that on that album that people will be surprised at, because a lot of people knew me for let's say fast fingers, tapping and slapping and all these things. And I really decided to try to do an album where I'm completely naked with just a pick.
We've talked before about your dexterity on your monster bass. Are you still playing the Andreas Neuber model?
The Snow Owl bass, which we developed together. I mean, my sound doesn't exist without it. And we developed something that is just for me literally a cultural stamp of a six string contra bass guitar sound. So that is always with me. You see it behind me right there, and next to it the amazing fusion bag, which, by the way, on your intro where you mentioned all the different cities that we have met, I just want to point out that this is the same bag from day one. Like, I've never had any problems with the bag. The same bag that I've been carrying around the world, it's covered in concert, badges. This bag has been with me everywhere. I think it's got to be over 55 countries, if I'm correct.
Good grief. That's incredible. I was going to say, one of the questions I was going to ask you further up, or as we're on talking about countries now, with the Hans Zimmer Band, you tour and tour and tour, and I know that you love the cultural cities and getting out and looking at and getting amongst the people, especially New York, because that's got a big Colombian feel about it, do you think, New York itself?
Oh, absolutely. We have a joke in Colombia that the capital of Colombia is Corona, New York, because all the Colombians are living there.
One thing I didn't mention in your intro, award-winning, all that sort of stuff, I think it should be mentioned. Last year, you were voted best bass player in the world. How did that affect you? Did you just calm like you always are?
Well, now you're making me blush. Music Radar and the Bass Player magazine, Bass Guitar magazine as well, They had this initiative, and they nominated a list of, I think it's 20 bass players that they thought worthy of mentioning for that year. and they asked the public to vote, who do you think is the best one in the world? And to this day, I still cannot process the fact that so many people voted for me. Joel McIver, the editor, called me and he said, I'm sorry, he didn't call me. He texted me. He said, do you know who received, you know, triple more votes than Robert Trujillo from Metallica? And I mentioned another bass player. I said, oh, for sure that was, you know, Joe Dart, or for sure that was Stanley Clark or somebody else. And he told me that it's you. And I said, that's very funny, Joe. Thank you for the joke. And I laughed and I said, that's pretty cute. Who won? And he said, you won. I said, Joel, the joke is over. It's okay. And he said, Juan, you won.
That's fantastic. And it's well deserved too. I know we talked a little while ago, you might not remember, you were teaching somewhere. It might have been one of the Berkeley studios, New York, Boston colleges. I'm not quite sure where it was, but you said you often get asked by students, how do we become like you? How do we make money out of this? What do we do? And you said, that's not what you need to do. Think about your best mentors or who you should be approaching to learn from.
I never entered music as a monetary choice. And I never went about it seeking money. I went about it almost as if it would be some form of like religion or cult where all you want is spiritual enlightenment. And in order to get enlightenment, you need to be surrounded by the masters. And it just so happens, you know, that if you surround yourself with champions, you will be a champion. If you surround yourself with losers, you will be a loser. It's kind of, you know, the yin yang of everything. And it was a beautiful coincidence and circumstance that people actually would pay us for doing what we love. But the intention has never been money. The intention for me has always been growth, sharing, giving sound to the people who could not make sound. That's basically our role. The mission for me will always be to keep the integrity of the spiritual path. And that has nothing to do with money.
Brilliant answer, brilliant answer. And like you say, there's that camaraderie with it all. I was lucky enough in London to get on the tour bus with you. We went around a little bit and went backstage, did all the backstage stuff. And I could not get over, I said this before, the spiritualness and how everybody got on together. There was no I'm louder than you, the old-fashioned thing. It was wonderful. It's a really relaxed feeling.
We were so blessed to have you with us, you and your lovely wife that came along, and you came on a very special night in the O2 Arena. Tom Cruise was there. There was a lot of big names there that came to witness Hans Zimmer's mastery, which we so humbly interpret every night. And the reason why there's multiple generations in this band, which all have worked with Hans over the years. And there's a generational link between all of us to speak the sound of our time. And I think that's why it's come across and it's been received so well by the world.
Well, let's hope we get back out on the road and see you performing. Like you said, the Pirates of the Caribbean, the Mission Impossible, fantastic show I've seen. It really, really is a good show. Until then, take care. We'll speak to you soon.
Thank you so much. And as always, all my love to the Fusion family. You guys are the best. And I'm just honored to be a part of this amazing world that you have created to help us to carry our instruments around the world.
Bless you, Juan. We'll speak to you soon.
Bye-bye.